Hi, George here, and today we're going to be taking a look at how you can change the background to a studio style background using the Replace Background Guided Edit. Now I'm showing this in Photoshop Elements 2023, but this works in earlier versions of Photoshop as well. And take a look at my new course for Photoshop Elements 2023. I put a link for that right down there at the top of the description, and I cover all of the new features in 2023, and of course, everything else in the program as well. And we're starting off with this picture right here. Let's now go up to Guided. Make sure our picture is selected right down here. Just click on our picture down there at the bottom. Okay, now in here, you want to go over to the Special Edits, and you're looking for Replace Background. It's right here in Photoshop Elements 2023. It's in a different location in other versions. Things get moved around a little bit each version, but it'll have the same picture in here. So look for that picture, and you're all set. We'll open this up. Now we're only using this just to separate the foreground girl out from the background and put in the basic image in behind. We'll do the rest of the work over in expert mode. So start off here with the select subject, click on that, and we'll let elements go in and find our picture for us. And did a pretty good job. See, it messed up right here. It messed up here on the hand. It's a little bit messy down here, left-hand side. We can fix all that stuff easily enough. I'll start off here with the quick select brush, and I want to remove this bit of the selection. So let's come down here. You have new, add, or subtract. Click on subtract. It's a pretty small brush size, but that will work in here. Just brush in here like that, and that cleans up that little section, so that's fine. At the top here, we have this hand. I want to add this into the selection, so let's come down here. I'll switch over to add, and then we'll brush along the hand. Now, it's bringing in a little bit of the background that I don't want up there, so I'll switch tools for that. And if that, I'll go over here to the brush tool. Now, with the brush tool, you can change the matte you're seeing back here if you want to, but I like using red. I think it's really easy to see this way. Now I want to subtract this from our current selection, so I'll go back down here and click on subtract. There's the brush size. And I'm just going to come in here and just do this by hand. I'll just be careful. We'll double check this over inside of expert mode and do a better job over there. But this will get us close. Okay, that's good. We'll now go down to the refine brush tool. Notice how our mask stays the same, but the tool changes. We have this new kind of odd tool. This is the refine brush. This is different than the refine brush that you normally will see. Does the same thing, but it looks a bit different. It isn't in its own little floating dialog box. It's down here in the options section. You can adjust your size, your snap strength, and your selection edge. I'll leave all those at the defaults. You can change the view here from overlay to on black or on white. I'll leave that at overlay. And left-hand side over here, we can add to selection, subtract from selection, push selection, or smooth selection. Let's try the add to selection, see if we can get a better job here. And that's more what I wanted right there. It depends upon what you're doing on how it's gonna work out. Now we'll need to clean this up also over in expert mode. It's not gonna be perfect, but it's close. It brings in or keeps those little small hairs. Okay, looking along the edge, I think everything else is fine in here. So that's our basic selection. The next thing we'll do down here is come down and you can come in and do a preset. This is where your new backgrounds are that have been added in here in Photoshop Elements 2023. We don't want those. We just want to go over here to import photo. And I found a photograph over on Pixabay, which we'll be using, and I have it right over here. I'll put a link for this in the description. So click on that, choose place, and it puts that new background in here, replacing the old background. Let's now go over into expert mode and do some cleanup work on this. For that, come down, click on the next button, and then in expert right here, and here we go. So the top one up here, this is our foreground subject. The next one is our new background right here, and the back layer here, this is the original image. Okay, first thing I want to do is just to clean up our edges. Notice we have a little bit of haloing in here, a little bit of a light line around some of the dark edges. And we may want to be a bit more careful right along the edge of the hand here. Let's do the hand first. We'll zoom in on that. Yeah, I can be a bit better on that. And that's going to be on the mask side right here. Now with the mask, black hides, white shows. I want to hide this stuff, so I want black in the foreground. And that's the default setting over here. So that's like that, that's good. Grab our paintbrush, make sure it still says black. Sometimes this will switch when you switch your brush, so just double check that. And we have a soft edge brush, that's okay. It's kind of a soft edge here anyway. And I'm just going to freehand this and just come in and just get rid of a little bit more of that background that showed up in there. Doesn't need much, just a little bit of a touch here and there. And right along here, there we go, like that. And a little bit right down here. And that should be good enough. Okay, let's take care of these little light spots along the edges. This is easy to do. go right here to this tool. This is the burn tool, and we're still on the layer mask. I'm going to bring my size down a bit, just like that. And what this will do is I'm going to darken down the edge of the layer mask right along those edges that are light. It just kind of forces that a little bit more in. Now, if you hold the space bar down, you can move your picture, and I'll just walk around the edge and get any of those spots that look a little bit too light. This is a way of increasing the contrast along your selection, and that sometimes is all you need to do to clean things up, like right in here, just a little bit on there and right down in here. There we go. And down this edge, and we'll check the other side in just a second, but I think we're going to be just fine here. Can't tell here because the background is pretty light in here, so I'm going to do the whole edge anyway. Okay, let's move over to the other side. Again, whenever you see that hand, I'm holding down the space bar, and we'll just get this whole edge here just to tighten things up a little bit. And just brushing several times like that, and just darkening down that edge, or actually making the black part of the edge more contrasty, and that gives us a harder edge, which is all we need. And let's finish this up along this side. There we go. And we're up in here, a bit right there, and then a bit right in here, and I think we're going to be okay on this. There we go. Now, at this point, it's going to look pretty good, but the background isn't where I want it yet. We can do a lot on the background and make it look much more like a studio background as opposed to some fabric, which is what I use, kind of a close-up on fabric. Okay, that looks fine. Back to the zoom tool and fit on screen. There we are. Now, I'm not really happy where she's sitting, so I'll just take my mouse and just push over here so that her face is basically in the middle of the picture, like that. Okay, the foreground looks good. Let's now work on the background. Here's our fabric layer right here. I'm going to right-click on this, and let's duplicate that layer. There we go. And I'll hide that one. Just in case things get messed up, I can always go back to my duplicated layer right here. So let's go up to Filter, come down to Blur and Gaussian Blur. I'm just going to move this up until that blurs out so I no longer see the actual patterning. I'm leaving a little bit up here, some of the lines, that's fine. I just don't want that real close-in patterning to look like that. So for this picture, it looks like it's up here around 5 or 6 maybe. Looks pretty good. We're keeping the lights and darks, but losing the texture on that. Let's now add a bit of a vignetting in here. You can do that up with the filter. Come down to Correct Camera Distortion. And let's just back this out so you get the whole view. There we go. There's our corners. And right here where it says Vignette and Darken, move that clear to the left and choose OK. Not dark enough. We're going to do this 2 more times. Filter, Camera Distortion, same thing. Move that clear to the left. And OK. And then 1 more time. Filter, Camera Distortion, and then clear to the left. There it goes. So there's nice vignetting in here now. Let's now give this some texture. Go to Filter, come down to Filter Gallery. Texturing is right here. And go over here, bottom right-hand corner, this is the texturizer. And then I have mine set for Canvas. It puts a nice little canvas effect. Now you can adjust the scaling in here. I have mine clear to the right-hand side. If you add in more relief, it gets more pronounced. I'm leaving it down pretty low. I just want just a little bit of a texture in there. Choose OK. That looks nice. So we've replaced what looked like a close-up texture with what looks like a far-away texture. So that's much better looking. And now let's put in some kind of a cloudy effect in here. Let's make a duplicate of this layer, right-click, and Duplicate Layer. Choose OK. There we go. Now go up to Filter, come down to Render and Clouds, and it gives you this kind of a thing. And notice how I converted that layer to this new cloud layer. We're now going to blend this in with the layer underneath. Go up here with the Blend Modes, and come down to Soft Light. And that gives us a kind of a patterning effect in there. If you like this video, hit the like button, click on share, click on subscribe, and take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop Elements. There's a link for that right down there at the top of the description.